everyone. My name is Marissa Barnathan. I use she, her pronouns, and I'm so excited to be here with you all through Horizon at Home. I know this is a really difficult time, and I just wanted to send my support and positive thoughts out to everyone. I'm really grateful to Theater Horizon for making this possible to support artists like myself and teaching artists in this time, and also to be able to provide some programming for you all at home. So again, my name is Marissa. We're going to be treating this hopefully in a way that's interactive. So I'm going to ask, you know, if you're watching this at home, anywhere in your house, if you know you want to stand along with me, that's great. If you prefer to sit, anything is okay. Just make yourself at home for this video. So this is Vocal Coaching 101. Where, you know, we're going to be focusing really on keeping our voices healthy, particularly for singing, but you can use this for public speaking or anything when you really just need to warm up your voice at the beginning of a day or before doing any big speaking or singing. Also, just to give you a little background about myself, I am from Havertown, Pennsylvania, originally in Delaware County. I now live in South Philadelphia, South Philly, and I am a theater artist. I wear a few different hats, like to say. I am an actress. I am also a teaching artist, obviously. And then I also direct and choreograph shows and musicals in the Philadelphia area. So if you want to learn more about me, my website is www.marissabarnathan.com, and you can follow me there. But I can give you more of those details later. So that's who I am, and I've been connected with Theater Horizon since 2010, actually, when I was an intern. Wow. So I'm very, very excited to be doing this video today. So I think let's jump in. So you know who I am. I hope you all are enjoying from home, and we're going to jump in. So first up, I'd like us to talk about breathing. So I'm going to actually stand for this. We don't need the piano. So again, you know, find a spot in your house where you feel comfortable. So breathing. So I talk about with my students low belly breaths. So you're going to see, I'm actually going to go to the side, and hopefully you can sort of see using this like I would in if I had a mirror in a regular class. So putting my hand here for a low belly breath. So a lot of times we think about breathing like it's just here. Right? I don't know if you can see from the camera, right? That's a shallow breath. We don't want that. That's like just raising your shoulders or your chest. It's shallow. It's not going to help you very much for good, healthy singing. So instead, we want our low belly breath, okay? For my, you know, maybe more advanced friends, it's called our diaphragm is down here. For my younger friends, you just want to think about in your belly, the low belly. So what we're going to do is, and anybody of any age can do this, so we're going to breathe in and pretend like we're filling up a balloon, and our stomach is the balloon. So I'm gonna come to the side, see if you can sort of see my balloon getting bigger. So I'm gonna breathe in and breathe out. So it's kind of counterintuitive to a normal balloon, right? You would blow up the balloon, but when we're breathing in, that's actually filling up our balloon. And then when we breathe out, the balloon gets smaller. Okay, so let's try that again. Breathe in. Breathe out. Okay, I'm gonna face back this way. So it's a helpful tool, I think, to put your hand on your stomach. So again, now we're gonna breathe in and breathe out, but now we're gonna do it on just a sigh. So I love, you know, as we go along, please try these with me. So yes, I'll demonstrate the thing first, but then you can do it along with me. Okay, so we breathe in, sigh it out. Good, and this is also even just helpful. Those sighs are good, depending on, especially if you're doing this early in the morning, to really kind of work out the kinks of our voice even before we put any notes to our vocalizing. So try that again. Breathe in, breathe out with a sigh. Good, now we're gonna breathe out with a hiss. So we breathe in and you're gonna hiss out, like just a little bit of air is escaping through your lips. And you can do this with me. I'd love for you to do it with me. We're gonna have different lengths of our hiss. So, you know, I'm gonna go as long as I can, but I'll leave a little space afterwards so that you can maybe hiss even longer depending on your capacity. And if you can't stretch as long, that's okay too. All right, so ready? Breathe in and hiss it out. Good. All right. Hopefully you did well at home. All right. So that's my main quick demo on breathing. And again, this is vocal coaching 101. So, you know, these are just the basics. And if you like what you see, you can contact me or the Theater Horizon Education Department, and we can give you more tips on your how to use your voice and, maybe even set up one-on-one lessons if you're interested in taking that next step as a singer or a vocalist. All right, so now I'm going to move to the piano. So we talked about breathing, and I am primarily a singer and a vocal coach when it comes to music. I am not a professional piano player, but I can play enough for the purpose of our video today and for voice coachings and voice lessons. So just so you know, and this is my at-home setup, as you know, all of us are doing our creative endeavors from home these days. All right, so we're gonna do a hum, okay? So first, let's just try that without a pitch. And you're gonna notice I use my hands a lot when I'm teaching voice, because also I'm a choreographer and I do movement. So I find that it's important for us to engage our bodies too. Those are always just options. If you don't want to do any of those hand gestures, you do not have to, but it's an option that you can include. All right, so Okay, so now we're going to do that hum. We're going to do it starting, I'm on a middle C, if you're following along at home. And so we're going to go Okay, so that's just a fifth, again, for anybody who's a music person. So I'm going from C to G, back down to C, okay? All right, so I'm gonna sing it once and then I'd like you to follow along with me, all right? So it goes, do that with me. Then we're gonna go up, and I'll be going up in half steps, all right? So I'm either gonna play the chord or our first note. And we're going from here, up to here, back down, all right? So let's try that together, starting here, here we go. Next one. Good, follow along with me. Good, next one, there we are. Next one. Okay, good, we're gonna pause there for a second. So you'll notice in my voice and probably in your voice, I am a female identifying person, and so regardless of your gender identity, we all have breaks in our voices. So for me, the break is often in this little crunchy area around a B, C, D, okay? But again, regardless of your gender identity, there's probably gonna be somewhere in your voice that you're gonna be flipping from a more chest voice type sound to a head voice type sound. And even with more masculine identifying folks, you know, that head voice or falsetto is what it's sometimes called for male folks, or male identifying folks. Whereas with the female identifying folks, or non-binary that are more femme, we've got this kind of head voice lighter sound, but falsetto and head voice are pretty synonymous. So just to give some of those terms in our vocal coaching 101. All right, so anyway, what I was saying is that when we get to the break, it's probably gonna sound different, and that's okay. I know that, especially when I'm singing first thing in the morning, that I often struggle in my break area, and your voice is probably gonna crack, and that's okay. I'm starting a new thing, hashtag embrace the cracks. It might be a thing already, but that's what I like to say to myself. This is especially a time where we need to be kind to ourselves. So embrace the cracks. My voice is probably gonna crack. It's okay if your voice cracks. Just embrace it, all right? So hashtag embrace the cracks. Here we go. So we're gonna come back to our let's see where we are. We were at an F, okay? Going up that fifth. So So listen first and then join back in with me. Remember, embrace the cracks, it's okay. All right, here we go. Try it with me here. Next one. Next one. And really try to lean into the, you know, the swell of that, the scooping through your voice. That's why I do this with my hand, all right? So sorry to stop us, but adding some important things in here that I would do the same thing if we were in person together. All right, so we've got, this was our, where were we? On the G. All right, so here we go. Do it with me. Next one. Next one. Next one. All right, we're gonna pause there. So that was an F. And I'd say, you know, for most of my students, I probably stop around an F, especially when we're first starting. I'll get a little higher later on, but when we're, you know, this is just really our first time putting some notes to our voices, we want to be kind to ourselves. All right, so that's an F. So yay, you've done hums. Good job. All right, so next we're going to move to lip trills, which you may have done. They're similar to a raspberry, which actually one of my voice teachers, Jenna Pastuzik, she's a wonderful performer and voice teacher, who is currently my voice teacher, actually. Even the teachers have teachers. And she's wonderful, so she often does raspberries that look like this. My tongue is gonna stick out, right? You might do it like a silly, you know, na 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 na. But now we're gonna be putting a pitch to that. So you'd be going, you can just practice that with a little sigh. But what I like to do, because that's kind of messy, right? You can do raspberries if you want. If that's easier, go for it. But it's a little messy. Get some spraying, especially in these days of COVID-19. Another option is just a normal lip trill where your tongue is not stuck out and you're just going to go. So just try that, blowing air between your lips. I'm sort of going to show you from a few different angles, but. I'm just doing a little sigh with my lip trill, okay? So try that, and it's okay if your lips don't quite make the vibration. That's all right. I've been doing this for years and years, and as long as you're getting some movement going in your lips, it's okay. Also, I tell my students, you might get a little tingly in your nose. That's all right. It's part of the process. All right, so I think we're gonna do the same pattern we had before. So vocally, melody-wise, it's gonna be the same note pattern that we had before, those fifths, with the same thing we did with our mms. So we're going up and back down, but now we're gonna do it with a lip trill, all right? So it sounds like this. And I'll go a tiny bit faster this time, okay? Since we're now progressing into our second warm-up. All right, so try it along with me this time. Here we go. Choices, all right? Oh, very, very good. All right, so we've done breathing, we've done mms, we've done lip trills. We're now gonna move to ya, going down. I just call this one ya, 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 ya. All right, so it's going to be a fifth again, but now we're gonna be descending. So instead of ascending and going up like we did with the mms and the lip trill, we're now going down. So I think we're gonna start on the C above middle C. So here's middle C. We're gonna start in the C above middle C. A little bit lower than where we stopped with our lip trills, but I find, you know, especially given our different ranges, it might be a little easier to bring us in here. Now for me, this is in my break area of my voice, and you know, I'm not sure for you all at home, but it's okay. I still would like us to try our best to lean into the yeah. For me, ah is a hard vowel sometimes, but E is a little easier. So I can really resonate, right? We haven't talked much about resonators yet, but you've got resonators here and different parts of your face to resonate, to get the sound resonating. And hopefully after doing the ums and the lip trills, your voice is a little more warmed up to be able to make this bigger sound now, all right? So it's gonna go, yah, 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 yah. Also, I should mention, now we're gonna be opening up our voices a bit. You might hear that I have what's called vibrato in my voice. Sometimes, not always. Depending on the show or that I'm in or the song that I'm singing, the style, you know, different singers might add vibrato or straight tone or something else. But in musical theater, which is most of what I perform and work on, we're often asked to do vibrato or straight tone. So what I'm just gonna ask while you're following along with me today, yes, I want you to sing the same notes as me, but you know, I wouldn't want you to try to match my vocal tone per se, as you know, some of you may have your own vibrato, which is wonderful. No matter your age, you know, that hopefully comes in naturally if that's something you want in your voice, or straight tone, and all are beautiful. So you know, at moments my voice might be in vibrato, it might be in straight tone, just letting you know. And again, so what that would sound like is is vibrato, that vibrating, or straight tone, okay? So just to you know, again, reiterate that for you at home, sing however your voice naturally comes out. All right, so here we go. We're gonna be going down, starting here. Try with me. We go, yah, 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 yah. Then we're gonna go down, yah, 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 yah. Next one, yah, 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 yah. Next one, 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 yah, 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 yah. Okay, so now you'll notice, hopefully, so pause for a moment, we're getting below the middle C, right? We started this humming on the middle C, but now again, that our voice is hopefully a little bit more warmed up, we're gonna dip a little lower. If at any point it's too low, you can totally drop out, that's fine, wait for me to finish. If you, you know, wanted to take it up the octave, you can, but just know you have options, all right? Everyone's voice is different, and that's okay. All right, so where were we? We were here. So we're gonna start here and go down. Ready? Yah, 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 and down. 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 Yah, 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 yah. One more. Yah, 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 yah. Alright, so that's an F. So now, in our vocal warm-up so far, we've gotten from F below middle C, the next F, up to another F. So that is about two octaves, which should be pretty good for most of you following along at home. You know, some of my younger friends, that might even be hard. And some of my older friends, perhaps you're, you know, getting a little higher or lower on either end. But pretty good to have those two octaves there. Alright? Okay, so that was our yah. So I have two more in store for you, and now we're gonna add words. Oh my goodness, we went from just breathing to adding some sound, to adding our lips, to adding our singing, and now we're gonna add some words. So, in honor of our friends in Italy who are certainly hurting, we're gonna do one called Bella Signora, which is in Italian, Bella Signora. I believe it means beautiful woman. All right, so again, just say it with me, Bella Signora. Good, so if the flipping the R is difficult, kind of similar to Spanish, I myself speak Spanish, so I say it in that way, and I'm used to that R, flipping the R, but if that's new to you, you can always just use our regular American R, Bella Signora, that's okay too. All right, so we're gonna do this in octaves. All right, so we just ended here on the F. We're gonna go up, listen, it goes like this. Bella Signora. All right, and again, I encourage you with this one to use your hands, all right? I'm probably going to use one of my hands while the other one's playing the notes. Bella Signora. And what that does, if you choose to use your hand, is that it really frees up your voice and your body and hopefully gets you thinking more about a forward motion with your voice instead of just being stuck in one place. All right? So again, that was Bella Signora. All right, so now we're gonna go up. So sing it along with me. Here we go. Bella Signora. Next one. Bella Signora. And up. 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 Bella Signora. Bella Signora, and up. Bella Signora, and up. Bella Signora, two more. Bella Signora, good last one. Bella Signora. Beautiful. Good job, friends. Very, very nice. All right, so hopefully that went okay on your end. I know that one's a little bit more tricky, but really just getting us thinking about singing in a legato form. So some of you music folks will know this, but legato, I like to think of, I usually say to my students, languid. The word languid, or, you know, if you're not sure what that means, flowy, right? Legato, liquid legato is another good L words to be thinking about with legato means flowy. All right, so Bella Signora. If you want to try another one there with me, getting really languid. Bella Signora. All right, so in opposition, so opposite from legato, we have the other kind of singing technique or, you know, vocal style, or really musical style, staccato. And these are both Italian words, so again, continue in the Italian trend. So staccato, and I usually think of like staccato, stick, that those words help me, or, you know, it's really sharp, you know, close, not quite the same alliteration, but still some S words, that the staccato is quick, and it's like quick little sharp, you know, stick movements, I guess, is one way to think about it, for staccato, all right? So staccato we're going to use in our last and final vocal warm-up in this vocal coaching 101. Oh, the time went so fast. At least it did on my end. I don't know about on yours. But I've been having a blast. So this last one is a ever popular one in the musical theater realm. And perhaps some of your other teachers at Theater Horizon have used this one or in other places. It is called Mommy Made Me Mash My M&Ms, a classic. So let's just say the text first. And this is also good to help us start using our articulators, which are the lips, the teeth, the tip of the tongue, right? You can even practice that as a little tongue twister if you want. The lips, the teeth, the tip of the tongue. The lips, the teeth, the tip of the tongue. Ooh, even I messed up. Let's try it again. The lips, the teeth, the tip of the tongue. Very good. All right, so those are, that's an example of warming up our articulators. But now we're going to use those same skills in Mommy Made Me Mash My M&Ms. So listen to me first, and then you'll say it. Mommy made me mash my M&Ms. Try it with me. Mommy made me mash my M&Ms. Very good. All right, so now we're going to put it to music. All right? We're going to use our same fifth here, going from C up to G back down. And it'll sound like this. Mommy made me mash my M&Ms. Mommy made me mash my M&Ms. All right, so that's how it's gonna go. And now I'd like you to try it along with me. Here we go, give it all you got. Mommy made me mash my M&Ms. 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 Mommy made me mash my M&Ms, two more. Mommy made me mash my M&Ms, last one. Mommy made me mash my M&Ms. Whoo! Coaching 101 here at Horizon at Home with Theater Horizon's Education Department. Hurrah! I'm so proud of you all. I can't wait to hear some of your feedback or see some comments. Please let us know what's working, what isn't, any fun experiences you've had doing this at home with your family. If there are any other topics that you would love to see in our Horizon at Home series, please let us know. Just checking my notes here. And also just another big thank you to Theater Horizon for allowing me to participate in this wonderful program. It's, again, really important to support artists at this time. And thank you to all of you for tuning in at home. This was really fun, and I hope, you know, this has brought some joy to your day. I think music makes the world go round. So thank you so much.